Sunglasses and Advil. Last night was mad real. Or in this case, sunglasses and cappuccinos. Last night we went out for Rob's birthday and we were involved in some drinking. Guys, we're not joking when we tell you that we don't drink. We don't really like to drink. And this, the aftermath, this is why.
You know that feeling when your stomach is just like super sour? That's where I'm at right now.
May this cappuccino revive us. So Max just called me and said something that like, I think the police stopped him or something. So I gotta go, I don't know, I gotta go find him and figure this out.
¿Cómo estás? ¿Todo bien? ¿Qué pasa?
Buen día.
Buen día, ¿cómo estás? Bueno, es su primera vez en Aldea Zama y él no sabía que solo es una dirección.
Nice, bro. First day in Tulum and I said talk the police out of giving Max a ticket.
I thought they were like throw me in the car and go to Mexican jail, dude. The lady literally told me that the cops are going to try to stop me and try to get money from me. I was like, what if that's confusing? And then she's like, yeah, tell them you live here. This is your friend Scooter. I was like, do you want me to go down like a rabbit hole of lying? Like,
I think the fact I speak Spanish is like a superpower here because I've never been taken advantage of every time we've come. But I guess that's bienvenido a Mexico, man.
Man, I just got this scooter. I dropped it on my leg. These things are kind of hard to.
Funny thing is, when I went over, the cop gave me like a pound. He's like, oh, all right, this is the guy that speaks Spanish. All right, final step of the hangover cure. A little bit of top secret pre-workout. I want you to pick which of these flavors you want to try.
This one.
This is from the upcoming supplement brand. A couple of flavors we're considering, so I'm curious to see what you think.
Pour it all in there?
Yes, pour it all in there. Probably not too much water.
Smells good. Pretty good, dude.
This is, I personally, I give this like a 9 out of 10. I think we could like crank up the intensity of the flavor a little bit, but
yeah.
This is good shit.
It's good. Is it, what version sample is this?
This is version 1.
Oh. That's pretty top tier, baby. I can feel it flowing through my body. Bro, workout complete.
Now I got someone that I want to introduce y'all to. Wait, before that, you know it's important to make gains, right? Like physical gains.
I'm trying to.
Do you know what else is maybe even more important?
What, David?
Mental gains.
You're right, man.
And that's why I want to say thank you to BetterHelp for being the sponsor of today's video. In 2022, I'm setting a new mental health goal for myself. I want to get better when something goes wrong at catching myself before I fall into all this negative self-talk and start feeling depressed. And one of the best ways to follow through on healthy mental health habits is by working with a licensed therapist. With BetterHelp, you can access their network of over 20,000 licensed therapists. And look, this is not a crisis line. This is not self-help. This is professional therapy done securely online. BetterHelp will assess your needs and then match you with your own professional licensed therapist. If you've ever searched for a counselor in your area, you know it can take weeks or even months just to get a call back. With BetterHelp, you can start communicating in as little as 48 hours. It's available to clients worldwide. You can log into your account anytime to message your therapist. Plus, you can schedule weekly phone or video sessions to chat with your therapist. Like, you never have to wait in one of those awkward waiting rooms. It's more affordable than traditional therapy. You're free to change therapists to make sure that you get a great match. And because BetterHelp is sponsoring today's video, you can go to betterhelp.com/beast to join over 2 million people taking charge of their mental health. That is betterhelp.com/beast to get 10% off your first month. Click that link down in description. All right, Beast Nation, I want to introduce y'all to, without any further ado, this is Taylor.
Hello.
She's the girlfriend of Max.
She's with me.
She's with him.
First time I've been able to say that in a long time.
Ever since Max has been on my channel, and a lot of my content is like dating advice and stuff like that, there's been a lot of comments speculating who he may or may not be dating. So hopefully this can put it into the comments. So I'm gonna split y'all up and ask you a question, because I wanna get the truth about something here. All right, so my question is, what did Max do to get you hooked? Like, at what moment were you like, okay, I'm hooked?
Oh God, I would have to say when I was sick, not with the C, but with just a normal cold. And he's like, if you're sick, I'm sick. And he just wanted to take care of me.
Like the first time that you guys hung out, what made you think like, okay, this guy's an option?
Because we just had a great conversation. It was so easy. There was never a dull moment. He genuinely made me laugh. If I can meet somebody that's funnier than me, then I knew he was the one.
The one.
Oh God.
Max is gonna be quite excited when he sees this. What did you do up front to hook her in?
You know what's crazy is, I think the thing that did it is that the first two times that I ever met her, I didn't try to hit on her. It wasn't even like a thought in my mind to try to pursue her. It was just like casual encounters, and then it just happened.
So you think like you kind of like disqualified her? So she was like, oh, why isn't he interested in me?
No. It's just more like it was, I think, a very natural, a natural meeting.
Would you say she's the one?
I think she's the one for me. I think that like,
y'all both said that.
Really? Oh shit.
It's a very, very heartwarming story. I'm happy for you guys, man. I'm happy.
I'm happy.
All right, so in order to give Taylor a proper warm welcome to the crew, today we're gonna do a couples competition. So it's gonna be Team Beast, myself and Julia, against Team Dude.
Team Dude's gonna take the gold.
Hell no.
Three competitions. We're gonna do a sprint, we're gonna do a wheelbarrow, and a long jump. I'm feeling confident, but Max has been talking a lot of shit.
It's just the inner winner in me, dude.
All I know is winning.
Oh.
Okay. Call me DJ Khaled, because all I do is win.
I'm being honest, I don't think they have a chance.
No, we're super athletic. Not that they're not, but.
But we are. For the first event, we will have the sprint, where the women will race to the men, and the men will race back to the finish line.
On your mark. Get set, go!
Want to know to get started. I almost lost it. At the end, I was trying to do the Usain Bolt, and Max is pretty fast.
We just need to worry about winning.
Not fast enough. Second will be the combined long jump. So me and Max will jump from this line, and then where we land is where the girls start from. The longest distance wins.
You guys got me in the first half, but I'm coming for you the second and the third, so be ready.
Yeah, we'll see. We'll see, Taylor.
So we're a little unclear on the official marking rules. We were essentially in the same spot, so the girls had the same line to start from. Let's go, squad. Let's go, Team Beast. Oh, that's an easy W right there.
Yo.
2-0.
They can't even. You guys can't even win now.
Yeah, we still got to do it. We still got to do it.
We may not win this competition, but I did win the heart of Max Chin.
So the wheelbarrow here, this is just for your pride.
It's just for fun, so at least I can win one.
On your mark, get set.
Bro,
good victory, man. You deserve it.
Thank you, sir. What do we tell y'all?
Gains, bro.
Athletes.
Hello? No. Woo! Let's go, David!
Whoa!
What the hell, bro? Gains!
That was my first one.
Doing it.
I should.
First ever backflip not into a pool. Damn.
You guys are ching ching, as they say in Spanish.
So you know Game of Thrones, right?
I've seen 5 minutes of it.
So it's a show that a lot of people like to watch.
I'm aware of it, yeah.
Oh, okay. But, yeah. For me, Tulum is like Game of Thrones. I watched the first episode of Game of Thrones, and then everybody else discovered it like 2 years later, and then everybody thought it was their thing, and I was like, that's my thing.
Are you saying you made Tulum popular?
I'm saying we've been coming to Tulum a long time, and then all of a sudden, it seems like the whole world found out about Tulum, and it's like, it's not our special thing anymore.
You know what's crazy? That's exactly how I feel about frozen margaritas.
Oh my god.
That's a great parallel.
Yeah, you specifically popularized Tulum in like my little world. I feel like I popularized frozen margaritas in yours.
Yeah, y'all know
we
I didn't.
Each other better people, dude.
This is true. The sum is better than the whole is better than the sum of its parts. And we're very happy to have Taylor as part of the squad.
Woo-woo! Cheers!
Woo-woo!
Arriba, abajo, al centro, adentro.
In mi mouth, though.
Sake. Pretty good. We are here with the crew. This restaurant is like, it's a fusion between Japanese and Mayan.
Sounds amazing, bro.
Sounds like a really good combination. We're here with Daryl also.
Hey, dude.
This is Max's friend. I mean, I consider you my friend now as well. You might remember him. He's the guy who lent me his suit on New Year's Eve.
He's also a certified dentist.
And he's a dentist.
Dr. Daryl.
Is that technically a doctor?
Yeah, doctor of dental surgery. I'm a surgeon.
There you go.
Look at that.
There you go.
I gotta say, we were very impressed with Daryl's moped skills. First time he's driven, and we were swerving around big potholes. Me and Julie, like, cut off a car in a turn, and he was behind us.
I was like, oh my god, are we gonna lose him? And he's, like, right there with us. Never drove one. I had to start it for him. I was concerned.
First time I drove a moped, crashed it, hurt both of our legs. Daryl gets on it at nighttime for the first time in wet road. No issues.
DDS on Sanford. Good job, dude.
This is my spicy drink friend.
Let's go.
Another spicy drink friend.
Spicy life.
Spicy life.
Watermelon friend.
Yeah.
That is so good.
It's not that spicy though.
Spicy passion fruit.
It has a little bite.
It's like a 9.5 out of 10.
So our first roll was a mango, salmon, avocado, a little sriracha on top.
Saying it's better.
And it's not really spicy. That mango is interesting though. I'll give that 9 out of 10.
I'll trade you one of my sushi.
Holy shit, this has got to be the best looking sushi roll I've ever seen. It's like crispy something with some shit on top and some
10 out of 10.
That looks like a 10 out of 10 and that tastes like a 10 out of 10. That means it's a 10 out of 10. Holy.
So good. Better than Nobu.
Arriba, abajo, centro, adentro.
So that guy's the owner of the spot. He gave us a shot. He's thinking about opening one in Austin. I'm trying to convince him he should do it because this is better than any sushi that I've had in Austin. Anyway, that was a delicious meal with delicious, not delicious friends, with good friends. Thank y'all for coming along and joining us for another day here in Tuluminati, Mexico. You got anything to say?
Appreciate you.
Appreciate you, bro. If you made it to the end of this video, hit the thumbs up button. Seriously, it helps the channel. If you're new to the channel, click subscribe and turn notifications on because I drop 2 new videos every single week and you don't want to miss them. A couple more Tulum videos coming your way. I will see you in the next one. Stay beastly.